Didn't this Gloria Pembroke have a child after she was acquitted?
That's where the moral lies. I think we might even get a minister to write it, to sort of give it tone.
To give it what, Mr. Reynolds?
To give it tone. Dignity.
Hello, this is Scott. Ask Dr. Leavenworth to step into this office immediately, will you?
You're getting a minister?
No, no, he's not a minister. He broadcasts a program for us. Oh, he's got the proper background for this job.
Excellent, Mr. Scott, excellent. Perhaps we could work a quotation from the good book into the continuity. Let me see. Something about the sins of the mother.
Sins of the who?
The mother. But your man can look it up.
Yes, I think he'd better look it up.
How do you do, Miss Simmons? Would you please announce me to Mr. Scott? He requested my presence.
Dr. Leavenworth's outside. Okay. Mr. Scott's at Mr. Reynolds' office.
Thank you, my dear. Thank you. How do you do, Miss Burke? You're looking most divine. You sent for me, Mr. Scott?
Oh, yes, Dr. Leavenworth. Come in. This is Mr. Reynolds, and over there is Mr. Banning.
How do you do?
Now, Doctor, I've got a little job for you. Do you remember the Gloria Pembroke shooting case about 15 years ago?
Oh, yes. Yes, a very dreadful murder. She shot a fine, upright young man.
Well, the jury didn't seem to agree with you. It was self-defense, I believe, wasn't it?
Oh, yes, of course. Just as you say, yes.
But it's the moral of the situation that we're interested in. She committed a murder, but notwithstanding the fact that it was justified, she was regarded as
As what, Dr. Leavenworth?
A woman of sin.
Exactly.
Now, Doctor, here's what I want you to do. I want you to write a play in 15 episodes based on that case. Now, how long do you think that'll take you?
Well, just long enough to refresh my memory.
And what'll we call it? That's important.
I have just the title for it. Sin Don't Pay.
Well, I think we'd better call it Sin Doesn't Pay. At least our grammar can be in good taste.
Yes.
Now, that'll be all, Miss Ross. And have Cora Latimer step into my office, will you? And, Doctor, will you come along in here with me now?
Yes.
Mr. Scott.
Yes?
I like this idea very much. I expect a lot from it.
Now, don't you worry. I'll give you the hottest play you ever heard.
That's the way I like to hear you talk.
Now, Miss Ross, put through a $5 raise for Tippy. He's thought of a new way to annoy the devil out of a million people.
Yes, sir.
Leavenworth, you're going to work with Miss Latimer. She's a new continuity writer, a present for Mr. Reynolds. O'Reilly, get the Princeton Rhythm Boys to follow Mother Andrew's cooking class. It's getting flat.
Yes, sir.
Well, Miss Latimer, you and Dr. Leavenworth are going to work together, and here's what I want you to do. I want you to hop over to the nearest newspaper office and dig back into the files of 15 or 20 years ago. You can get all the dope you want on the Pembroke case. You got it?
Quite so, sir. Quite so.
Did Hampton teach you to write in New Orleans?
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Scott. See, I used to be a newspaper woman.
Oh, you did? Well, we'll soon find out whether you can write or not. Now, you're going to work with the doctor. I'm not introducing you because I don't want to be responsible.
Responsible? What do you mean?
Well, you'll soon find out. Now, you're going to write a chapter play on this case, and I want you to handle the woman's angle. You got it?
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Scott.
Yes, I hope so. That's all. Oh, and don't ride in taxicabs with him. See what dope you can get on this.